Hi guys, my name is Anuj Jindal. Welcome to this session on ESIC Deputy Director Examination Development Issues. Development issues बहुत ही एक important और easy सा topic है जो कि ESIC के exam में आने वाला है. Keeping that in mind, I have come out with about 100 most important questions based upon the 100 most important topics that can be asked in the examination. What you have to do is figure out the topics or identify the topics which I'm going to cover today through these questions. और उन topics को आपको directly cover करना है if you're preparing on your own, अगर आप self study करके तैयारी कर रहे हैं तो आपको ये चीज़ ध्यान रखनी है. Okay? Before starting with the session, actual questions उठाने से पहले I would like to give you an idea about the course through the website itself. क्योंकि बहुत सारे students हैं जो कि regularly comment section में पूछ रहे हैं कि सर कोर्स कहाँ से ले, हाउ टू स्टडी, व्हाट टू डू, व्हाट नॉट टू डू, एटसेट्रा एटसेट्रा. कीपिंग दैट इन माइंड, अ कोर्स हैज़ बीन लॉन्च्ड और इस कोर्स की डिटेल्स मैं आपको बता देता हूँ. दो पार्ट्स में एग्जाम होने वाला है, पार्ट ए एंड पार्ट बी, एंड बोथ ऑफ देम आर गोइंग टू बी कंडक्टेड टुगेदर. आफ्टर पार्ट ए एंड पार्ट बी ऑफ द एग्जाम देयर विल बी एन इंटरव्यू स्टेज. सो द एग्जामिनेशन इज गोइंग टू बी हेल्ड इन टू स्टेजेस. स्टेज वन विल हैव पार्ट ए एंड पार्ट बी एंड स्टेज टू विल बी इंटरव्यू. Both of them, of course, are going to be covered in the syllabus itself, in the course itself. There is a 40% off discount going on presently on ESIC course. और इसमें सबसे important बात जो आपको याद रखनी है is that you need a minimum of 3 years experience in the government or autonomous sector. If you don't have the experience, you're not eligible. If you have the experience, it is a very good opportunity. Why? Because the number of posts are very good. 151 posts हैं, which is hell lot of posts, and that is why it is a very good opportunity. Grade A ki post hai sari ki sari. Now coming to the course, when you go to the website www.anujindal.in, you will see a section of by courses. There you will find ESIC, Employee State Insurance Corporation here. Okay, वहाँ पे क्लिक करोगे ये कोर्स आ जाएगा. कोर्स में डिटेल्स हैं. पार्ट ए में देर इज इंग्लिश लैंग्वेज एंड इन पार्ट बी यू हैव अ टोटल ऑफ 10 सब्जेक्ट. ओके, the entire course is being covered through the entire syllabus is being covered through this course. The original price of the course is 12,500, but because of Raksha Bandhan and various other festivals happening, there is a 40% discount. You can use this code ESIC40 and avail the discount. Enough with the details about the course, let's come to the questions now. Yes. ओके, सीधा डायरेक्टली फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन पे आते हैं. द क्वेश्चन सेज मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ न्यू एंड रिन्यूएबल एनर्जी हैज सेट अ टारगेट ऑफ इंस्टॉलिंग 175 गीगावाट ऑफ रिन्यूएबल एनर्जी बाय 2022. लास्ट सेशन में हमने ये क्वेश्चन भी उठाया था कि व्हाट इज द टारगेट टू बी अचीव्ड बाय 2022. नाउ वी आर अज्यूमिंग कि ये आपको पता है एंड यू रिमेंबर दिस. व्हाट इज द एलोकेशन टू सोलर एनर्जी आउट ऑफ दिस टोटल 175 गीगावाट. I had told you, I remember, I had told you in the previous session, previous class, previous questions, कि भाई allocation क्या है out of this 175 gigawatt, what is the allocation to different sectors in terms of installed capacity. हमें identify करना है in this question only the installation, the allocation to solar energy. You can write your answers in a piece of, on a piece of paper. And at the end of the session, ये answers आप जरूर comment section में डालिए. I mean your score, put it in the comment section below so that you can compare your score, your progress with other students. That will be a very good method of comparing your performance with others, because at the end of the day, the exam is relative. आपकी performance औरों के comparison में कितनी है, that will determine your success or your failure. Okay. Coming back to the question, the options are 50 gigawatt, 75 gigawatt, 100 gigawatt, 125 gigawatt and 150 gigawatt. Answer to this question is option C, which is 100 gigawatt. Answer pe aate hain. Let's go through the allocation once again. A target of installing 175 gigawatt of renewable energy capacity by 2022 has been set, which includes 100 gigawatt from solar, 60 from wind, 10 from bio and 5 from hydro. So is tarah se yaad kar sakte ho, 100 from solar, 60 from wind, 10 from bio and 5 from hydro. Okay, SWBH, very bad acronym, but is tarah se aap thoda sa yaad rakh sakte. You can create your own methods also in order to remember this. Maine bas isko chota kar diya so that it becomes easier for you to remember and visualize एट द एंड ऑफ द एग्जामिनेशन, जब जिस दिन आपका एग्जाम है, अगर ये क्वेश्चन आता है तो. ओके, लेट्स कम टू द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन. सेकेंड क्वेश्चन पे आते हैं. द क्वेश्चन सेज, विद रेफरेंस टू यूनाइटेड नेशंस फ्रेमवर्क कन्वेंशन ऑन क्लाइमेट चेंज UNFCCC, very important, remember the full form also, can be asked in the examination. Consider the following statements. Very good question, काफी अच्छी quality का question और difficult question है. It was adopted at the Rio Earth Summit. You need to have an understanding of the history of United Nations Framework Convention on Climate Change, जो कि course में कहीं ना कहीं covered है ESI में, economic and social issues में, तो यहाँ पर ये cover हुआ था. Okay? Adopted at Rio Earth Summit. It aims to stabilize greenhouse gas concentrations. Option number 2. It aims to stabilize greenhouse gas concentrations. Ye iska major target hai. Is it true or false? Green Climate Fund has been established under it. Is it true or false? Okay. We have to figure out which of the following options are correct and which are incorrect. Yes, it was adopted at Rio Earth Summit in the year 1992. That is when the entire history of UNFCCC started. Okay. Uske pehle commission aaya tha, jiski main bhi full form nahi bata raha hu, but it is one of the questions jo ki ya to aaj cover hoga ya fir further sessions mein cover hone wala hai. It aims to stabilize greenhouse gas concentrations. Yes, the primary target is reduction in CO2 gas concentrations in the Earth's atmosphere. Third is Green Climate Fund. Yes, this has been created under this itself. Iska jo total valuation hai, ye aapka target hai. You have to figure it out. This is your homework. Ye aapko pata karna hai. So read more on United Nations Framework Convention on Climate Change, Green Climate Fund ke andar, what is the allocation or distribution which is to be done every year by the developed countries. Wo aapko figure out करना है. The answer to this question is very easy. Option E, 1, 2 and 3, all 3 are correct. None of the options is incorrect. Next question पे आते हैं. Consider the following conventions. Now this is important question और ये difficult question भी है. I will call it a difficult question. Okay. Let's read the question and then we'll have a look at the answer options. Consider the following conventions. Number 1, Convention on Biological Diversity. Inki date of origin and the history you should be clear about. Ye course mein sare conventions covered hain at one place, so you will not find it very difficult to cover these conventions, because one of the major development issues is what? Sustainable development. So anything and everything related to sustainable development is important for our examination. वहां से questions आने ही वाले हैं. Very hot topic. Okay. Relevant also, not only hot. Convention on Biological Diversity, number 1. United Nations Convention to Combat Desertification, number 2. United Nations Framework Convention on Climate Change, number 3. Convention Concerning the Protection of World Cultural and Natural Heritage, number 4. Convention for Protection of Ozone Layer. Now the question is, the real question is, which of the above conventions derived directly from 1992 Earth Summit held in Rio de Janeiro, also called, or yahan pe likha hi hua hai, Earth Summit. Okay. Now previous question mein humne dekh liya, United Nations Framework Convention on Climate Change was derived out of the Earth Summit in 1992, so that of course is one of the answers. So dekho yahan pe three hai. We have to figure out the correct one. तो ये सारे हैं, so D is eliminated. We've eliminated only one out of this. ठीक है, कुछ तो हम closer आए. Now Convention on Biological Diversity, United Nations Convention to Combat Desertification, दूसरा, तीसरा हम clear कर चुके हैं, और चौथा और पांचवा, पांच दिए हुए यहाँ पर. Okay. One second. Sorry. यहाँ पर भी third दिया हुआ है, so we cannot eliminate this also. Yes. So we cannot eliminate even one, because third is available everywhere. So we know that the examiner understands ki bhai third to aapko pata hi hoga. Okay. Now Convention on Biological Diversity, ye jo hai, ye hua tha I think 1985 mein pass. So ye usse pehle pass hua hai. So ye isse derive hota hai I think. No, one second. Convention on Biological Diversity came in after the UNFCCC, and it was derived from UNFCCC summit. So this is one of the answer options. Desertification जो है ये भी बाद में आया था. So this is also one of the answers. Convention concerning World Cultural and Natural Heritage, इसको हम बोलते हैं World Heritage Convention. World Heritage Convention बोलते हैं इसको. World Heritage Convention, okay? ये क्रिएट हुआ था 1972 में नेचुरल और कल्चरल हेरिटेज को बचाने के लिए, टू प्रोटेक्ट नेचुरल एंड कल्चरल हेरिटेज, क्रिएटेड इन 1972. ओके, तो ये हमारा, दिस इज नॉट डिराइव्ड डायरेक्टली फ्रॉम 1992 वर्ल्ड समिट. व्हाई? बिकॉज इट केम बिफोर इट. तो जो भी पहले आए थे, इफ यू नो द इयर्स, इवन देन यू कैन फिगर आउट द एग्जैक्ट आंसर, बिकॉज बोथ ऑफ दीज केम इन बिफोर 1992 एंड द अदर थ्री केम इन आफ्टर 1992. Similarly, Convention for Protection of Ozone Layer, also called as Vienna Convention, ये आया था 1985 में. This came in 1985. Okay, so this is also not derived from the Earth Summit. So fourth और fifth हमारे eliminate हो जाते हैं. So whatever options have 4 and 5 can be eliminated. So our answer option is D, 1, 2 and 3. I hope this is clear. देखो, ये एक लंबा difficult question है जहाँ पर आपकी डेप्थ पूछी जा रही है, जहां पर पूछा जा रहा है कि आप समझा जा रहा है वेदर यू हैव प्रॉपर एनालिसिस एंड अंडरस्टैंडिंग ऑफ सस्टेनेबल डेवलपमेंट हिस्ट्री और नॉट. ओके, नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन पे आते हैं. द ह्यूमन डेवलपमेंट इंडेक्स इज अ स्टैटिस्टिकल टूल यूज्ड टू मेजर द कंट्रीज ओवरऑल अचीवमेंट इन इट्स सोशल एंड इकोनॉमिक डायमेंशंस. Human Development Index का question है, very favorite question. It comes every year in all the examinations in many forms. This is just one format. Okay. Which of the following is not an indicator? Indicators बहुत favorite part है examiner का. They have been asked regularly by the examiners. Life expectancy, expected years of schooling, mean years of schooling, infant mortality rate, gross national income per capita. You have to figure out which of the following is not one of the indicators. The answer option is D. Because health is one, so we might feel and get confused ki bhai infant mortality rate a direct indicator of health conditions in a nation, so it should be one of the indicators, but it is not. Let's have a look at the indicators that have been given or used under Human Development Index. So ye teen indicators hain major, long and healthy life, knowledge and standard of living. Ye aapko yaad rakhna hai. Knowledge matlab education, long and healthy life, that means health, and standard of living derives with or from wealth. Okay, what are the indicators? Life expectancy at birth, used through life expectancy index, that is the only indicator of health. Knowledge or education, expected as well as mean years of schooling, both are used. Dono hi use hote hain, dono yaad rakhne hain. Standard of living, gross national income per capita, PPP basis, you have to remember this. Okay, so ye hamare indicators hain, total of 1, 2, 3, 4 indicators that we can see here. Gross national income per capita, 1. Expected years of schooling and mean years of schooling, number 2 and 3. And life expectancy at birth, 4. There are 3 indicators, but total of 4 tools used under these indicators. Please remember this. Okay, let's come to the next question. Which of the following is not a correct measure of economic growth? Very simple question. Very simple question. If you have basic understanding of what growth is, what GDP is, what GNP is, basic macroeconomics, then I don't think this should be a difficult question. Reduction in economic inequality, reduction in social inequality, rise in GDP and rise in GNP. Kaun sa hai jo ki growth mein nahi measure hota, nahi use hota? You might confuse it with development. Do not confuse it with development. We are only talking about growth here and not development. Okay. Economic inequality, yes, when we use PPP, economic equality per capita, economic inequality of individuals in a nation, we are using it. We are measuring that. GDP and GNP, both of them are direct measures of growth. Social inequality helps us measure the status of development but not growth. ओके, ये हमें स्टेटस ऑफ डेवलपमेंट बताता है, ग्रोथ का स्टेटस नहीं बताता है. इट इज नॉट यूज्ड. सो सोशल इनइक्वालिटी इज नॉट अ पार्ट ऑफ मेजरमेंट ऑफ ग्रोथ. आई होप दिस इज क्लियर. सो दिस वॉज द एंटायर लिस्ट ऑफ क्वेश्चंस दैट आई हैड फॉर टुडे. आई होप यू लाइक्ड इट. आई होप इट वॉज हेल्पफुल. अपने स्कोर्स फाइनलाइज करके कॉमेंट सेक्शन में डालो सो दैट यू कैन कंपेयर इट एज आई सेड विद अदर स्टूडेंट्स, सो दैट आई कैन अंडरस्टैंड कि भाई लेवल क्या है स्टूडेंट्स का. बहुत सारे 5-on-5 आएंगे. आई विल इंक्रीज द लेवल ऑफ questions, the difficulty of questions in the further sessions as well. Okay, so this was all. Keep preparing for your examination. Very good exam, lot of vacancies, going to be very, very helpful for your future. All the best guys, take care, bye bye.